A 40-year-old female, pre-morbidly healthy, was admitted with fever since 3 days, sudden in onset, loose motions since 3 days, 12 episodes, associated with vomiting, 3 episodes per day for the last 3 days. There was left forearm swelling and pain below wrist since 3 weeks. She received enteric oxygen. In the past, there is history of polyarthralgias, swelling and pain below wrist 1 year back, and she was given painkillers. An arthritis workup was done. It showed elevated CRP and ESR. AMA was positive 3+. Rheumatoid factor and anti-CCP were negative. Uric acid was within normal limit. An ultrasound was suggestive of tenosynovitis. On examination, pulse rate was 76 per minute. BP was 110/70. Temperature was 99. And there was swelling on flexor aspect of left forearm just below the wrist, and systemic examination was not significant. On day 1, hemoglobin was 11.7, total count was 2200, platelet of 85,000, AST and ALT were elevated, bilirubin was 1.9, creat was 1.16, dengue and rapid malarial test were negative, chest X-ray was within normal limit, echo was normal. Ultrasound was suggestive of hepatosplenomegaly with minimal ascites, and procal was 3.98. She was started with metronidazole and ceftriaxone for acute gastroenteritis. On day 2, she started complaining of intermittent breathlessness and chest discomfort and fever. On examination, BP was borderline low with postural hypotension. There was tachycardia and decreased urine output. On auscultation, chest was clear. On auscultation, chest was clear. She was started on nasal oxygen in view of increased respiratory rate and shifted to ICU. In view of worsening clinical condition, pancytopenia and transaminitis, further evaluation was done. Ferritin was found to be increased 15,670, LDH was increased 1,456, triglyceride was 146, AMA blood test was positive for AMA N2. To summarize, a 40-year-old female with history of arthritis, synovitis, and positive for AMA in the past, admitted with acute gastroenteritis, has pancytopenia, elevated LFT, elevated ferritin and LDH levels, with ANA positive for AMA M2. Hence, the likely diagnosis is macrophage activation syndrome secondary to connective tissue disease. So, she was started with IV DEXA, 8 mg 12th hourly, hemogram and LFTs were monitored. On 12th, DEXA was started. Could be seen that the total count and platelet count improved and the transaminitis started settling down. She was discharged with stable vitals on DEXA 8 mg BD. Plan was to repeat hemogram, ferritin and LDH on OPD basis. During follow-up, her ferritin level reduced, LDH level reduced, ALT and AST also settled. So the final diagnosis is macrophage activation syndrome, secondary to underlying connective tissue disorder, exacerbated by acute gastroenteritis.